Let me first talk to you a little bit about Astra. Astra is a space company. We offer low-cost, frequent launch services for small satellites. We are based in the Silicon Valley, and we are the first public company to build rockets at scale. Our mission is to improve life on Earth from space. And we do that by empowering our customers. They do some amazing stuff, from powering affordable and efficient agriculture to providing broadband services to the unserved and underserved populations around the world, enabling them to get better health care, get better education, work remote, things that most of us take for granted. We see a tremendous opportunity in building the infrastructure of the space economy. It is worth more than $1 trillion, according to Morgan Stanley. Astra was founded in 2016 by Chris Kemp and Adam London with the goal of reshaping how the space industry works. Here you can see Adam and Chris literally in their garage on Harrison Street in San Francisco building Astra. Our superpower is speed. Speed is critical in evolving our business. We need speed to get to insights much faster so that we can do three things. Number one, we want to iterate fast. Number two, we want to innovate fast. And number three, we need to automate fast. So we intentionally built Astra on the cloud to ensure that we can get to data-driven decisions faster. One more thing about Chris. Chris drove OpenStack and founded Nebula. So it should come as to no surprise that being a cloud-first company is in our DNA. Leveraging the cloud is what really sets us apart from others in the industry that still rely on on-prem infrastructures and large data centers. We were the first company to get to space within 4 years of our inception. And after we got to space, within less than a year, we managed to reach orbit. And that's a major accomplishment. At Astra, our rockets are born digital. And by digital, we mean software and data. We are, in fact, bringing the learnings of the software world in a very different engineering and manufacturing environment. And that helps sets us apart from everybody else in our space. Everything from designing a part to sourcing materials to testing and flying our rockets to managing our financial information is done on the cloud. The beginning of the rocket building journey is digital designs and models that go through some rigorous simulations and tests. And that allows us to evolve our rockets much faster. Then we take those digital designs and we move to the hardware environment. We call it the mock-it. And this is where software meets hardware. This helps us evolve the rockets much faster than if we were just to go straight to hardware. Data is what drives Astra. We have large time series data that get generated from our tests, our concurrent simulations, and actually flying the vehicle. We also have a lot of events. Those events come from our supply chain, our manufacturing equipment, and really as a byproduct as people interacting with our systems. So the question is, how can we leverage our data? How can we harness the power that's within our data to accelerate our mission? And this is where AWS comes into play in helping us to make an impact. Here you can see a high-level architectural diagram. We use AWS glue and lake formation to create quickly and efficiently a single system of truth. The data lake is on AWS, and it houses the data that we actually use to build our machine learning models. Amazon Athena gives our internal customers, our engineers, and our data scientists the ability to query the data lake instantaneously. We also use Amazon Kinesis, and that allows us to really scale our telemetry pipeline. As you probably know, rocket launches must happen within some very specific conditions, and often they take place in remote locations around the world. Think of the rocket as an IoT device on the edge, where the edge can be in space. So leveraging AWS's global infrastructure ensures that we can have a resilient, interconnected, and highly available environment. Another interesting thing is that our manufacturing runs on the cloud, and it needs to scale. So today, we build about a rocket a month, and we're planning to go a lot faster than that. Imagine Astra being like a car manufacturer that builds, massively produces rockets instead of cars. Everything needs to come together just in time to assemble our rockets. And all of these things need to be secure and ITAR compliant, which is why we run it all on AWS GovCloud. As a result, we managed to get from generation one to generation three rocket within a few years. And compare that with others in the industry that take up to a decade to get to that point. In fact, we got to the launch pad within 60 days from our Vehicle 6 to our Vehicle 7. So what you see here is our Vehicle 7 that actually made it to orbit. So let me play the video for you. As we move forward, we are aiming at automating every possible aspect of our launch service. And we're also looking at building a lot more advanced capabilities. One example is creating a digital twin of our rocket by mapping every subsystem of the rocket itself to the digital equivalent. And that allows us to create much better predictive capabilities than what we have today. Another example is as our data grow, we need to be able to find it much, much easier. So we're looking at Alexa Lex and Kendra that will help us do exactly that. All right, so we are tremendously excited about how these efforts will allow our customers get to space quicker, more cost-effectively, and more reliably, so that they can bring to all of us positive outcomes. At Astra, we pride ourselves in earning our ability to learn fast, iterate, and automate through our technology. And we're really looking forward how these advancements will help all of us make life here on Earth from space. We're just getting started. There's a lot more to come. And with that, I thank you for your attention.